that little engine that could. Tug, 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 puff, 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 ding dong, ding dong, the little train rumbled over the tracks. She was a happy little train, for she had such a jolly load to carry. Her cars were filled full of good things for boys and girls. There were toy animals, giraffes with long necks, teddy bears with almost no necks at all, and even a baby elephant. Then there were dolls with blue eyes and yellow curls, dolls with brown eyes and brown bobbed heads, and the funniest little toy clown you ever saw. And there were cars full of toy engines, airplanes, tops, jackknives, picture puzzles, picture puzzles, books, and every kind of thing boys or girls could want. But that was not all. Some of the cars were filled with all sorts of good things for boys and girls to eat, being golden oranges, red-cheeked apples, bottles of creamy milk for their breakfasts, fresh spinach for their dinners, peppermint drops, and lollipops for after-meal treats. The little train was carrying all these wonderful things to the good little boys and girls on the other side of the mountain. She puffed along merrily. Then all of a sudden, she stopped with a jerk. She simply could not go another inch. She tried and she tried, but her wheels would not turn. What were all those good little boys and girls on the other side of the mountain going to do without the wonderful toys to play with and the good food to eat? "Here comes a shiny new engine," said a funny little clown who jumped out of the train. Let us ask him to help us." So, all the dolls and toys cried together, "Please, shiny new engine, we want you please pull our train over the mountain. Our engine has broken down." And the boys and girls on the other side won't have any toys to play with or good food to eat unless you help us. But the shiny new engine snorted, "I'll pull you. I am a passenger engine. I have just carried a fine big train over the mountain with more cars than you ever dreamed of. My train had sleeping cars with comfortable berths, a dining car where waiters bring whatever hungry people want to eat, and pillow cars in which people sit in soft armchairs and look out of big plate glass windows. I pull the likes of you." "Indeed not." And off he steamed to the round house, where rangers live when they are not busy, hustled the little train, and all the dolls and toys felt.
Then
the little clown called out, "The passenger engine is not the only one in the world. Here is another engine coming. A great big strong one. Let us ask him to help us. The little toy gun waved his flag, and the big strong engine came to a stop. Please? Oh! Please? Big engine, cried all the dolls and the toys together. Want to please pull a train over the mountain? Our engine has broken down. And the good little toys, the boys and girls on the other side won't have any toys to play with our good food to eat unless you help us. But the big strong engine bellowed, I am a freight engine. I have just put a big train loaded with big machines over the mountain. These machines print books and newspapers for grown-ups to read. I am a very important engine indeed. I want to put a lots of you. And the freight engine put off indignantly to the roundhouse. The train and all the dolls and toys were very sad. Cheer up, cried the little toy clown. The freight engine is not the only one in the world. Here comes another. He looks very old and tired. But our train is so little. Perhaps he can help us. So, the little toy clown waved his flag in the dinghy when the old engine stopped. Please, cried all the dolls and toys together. Want to please pull our train over the mountain? Our engine has broken down. And the boys and the girls on the other side won't have any toys to play with or good food to eat unless you help us. But the rusty old engine sighed. I am so tired. I must rest my weary wheels. I cannot pull even so little a train as yours over the mountains. I cannot. And off he rumbled to the roundhouse, chugging. I cannot. Then, indeed, the little train was very, very sad, and the dolls and toys were ready to cry. But the little clown called out, Here is another engine coming. A little blue engine, a very little one. Maybe she will help us. The very little engine came tugging merrily along. When she saw the toy clown's flag, she stopped quickly.
What is
the matter? My friends, she asked kindly. Oh, the little engine, quite the dolls and toys. Will pull us over the mountain. Our engine has broken down, and the good boys and girls on the other side won't have any toys to play with or good food to eat unless you help us. Please? Please help us. Little Blue Engine. I'm not very big. Said the little blue engine. Said the little blue engine. They used me only for switching trains in the yard. I have never been over the mountain, but we must get over the mountain before the children awake. Said all the dolls and the toys. The very little engine well looked up and saw the tears in the doll's eyes. And she thought of the good little boys and girls on the other side of the mountain who would not have any toys or good food unless she helped. Then, she said, I think I can. And she hitched herself to the little train. She tugged and pulled and pulled and tugged and slowly, they started off. The toy car jumped aboard, and all the dolls and the toy animals began to smile and cheer. Puff, puff, chug, chug, went the little blue engine. I think I can. Up, 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 faster and faster, and faster the little blue engine climbed until at last they reached the top of the mountain. Now in the valley lay the city. Hooray! Hooray! Cried the funny little clown and all the dolls and toys. The good little tall boys and the girls in the city will be happy. Because you helped us. Can little blue engine. And the little blue engine smiled and seemed to say yes. She puffed steadily down the mountain. I thought I could.